Okay, so today we will study how our transformer behaves when a DC supply is given to the primary side of the transformer. Okay, first let us make the code of the transformer. This one is the core of the transformer. This is the magnetic core made up of ferromagnetic material or graded silicon steel. Now I am giving winding on the primary side of the transformer. And on the primary side of the transformer, and this primary side of the transformer is given a supply. Which supply I will give? I will give DC. हमने जो ट्रांसफार्मर का प्रिंसिपल पढ़ा था वो एसी सप्लाई से पढ़ा था, सारे कुछ एसी थे. ओके, तो यहाँ एसी हमने क्यों दिया था? अगर एसी के जगह पे हम डीसी देंगे तो उस पर क्या इंपैक्ट पड़ेगा हमारे ट्रांसफार्मर के वर्किंग पर. हाउ ट्रांसफार्मर विल बिहेव व्हेन वी विल अप्लाई ए डीसी ऑन द प्राइमरी साइड ऑफ द ट्रांसफार्मर एज ए सोर्स. नाउ दिस वन इज द लोड. सपोज आई एम कनेक्टिंग लोड हियर. दिस वन इज द वोल्टेज वी. सपोज दिस वन इज द वोल्टेज वी एंड दिस वन इज द वायर एंड दिस वायर इज कनेक्टेड विद द कॉइल ऑफ द transformer. This coil is wrapped on this magnetic material. This square is the magnetic material. Okay, and this coil is wrapped on those magnetic material. When this wire is connected with this coil and coming back and getting connected from the other polarity of the source, other terminal of the source, voltage source applied. Okay, now this one is making the electrical circuit. This path is making electrical circuit. This V DC voltage will be given, one current will flow. When DC voltage will be given, a DC current I will flow. Okay, a DC current I will flow. Now suppose this one is the primary winding, then therefore consider the number of turn in this primary winding is N1 and number of turn in the secondary winding is N2. Okay. As I have discussed in the working principle of the transformer in my previous lecture, that when there is a turn and there is turn N1 in the winding of the transformer and I enters into that winding, then multiplication of that I and N1, that I and number of turns, gives the magnetomotive force MMF. Then MMF will develop in the primary winding of the transformer. MMF I N1 will, I can say this one is V1, this one is I1. Okay, I1 N1 will develop in the primary winding of the transformer. And now this MMF can be the reason to drive a magnetic flux in the core of the transformer. Means I1 और N1 मिलके एक MMF बनाया. जैसे electrical circuit में EMF बनता है, तो EMF जब होता है तो क्या होता है, फिर current flow करना शुरू करता है. वैसे यहाँ पे MMF develop हुआ, तो यहाँ पे अब इस हमारा मैग्नेटिक कोर में, मैग्नेटिक पाथ में हमारा फ्लक्स फ्लो करना शुरू करेगा. फ्लक्स विल फ्लो इन दिस पाथ. ओके, नाउ दिस वोल्टेज इज डीसी, डीसी वोल्टेज. देन करेंट प्रोड्यूस्ड विल बी डीसी. नाउ एमएमएफ विल बी I1 N1. दिस एमएमएफ विल बी डीसी इन नेचर. Because of this DC MMF, flux phi, you know there is flux developed in the magnetic core of the transformer and this flux will be DC. Okay, now this flux will also link with, this flux will also pass from secondary winding of the transformer, secondary coil of the transformer. Now, therefore, this same flux phi DC is getting linked with the both the coils N1, having number of turns N1 and N2. let us see what happens next. Now, as soon as flux is developed in the magnetic path of the material, there will be EMF will induce in the primary winding. Here, this one is the flux, and wherever when there is flux, you know there will be an induced EMF E1. E1 equal to N1 d phi dc by dt. Okay, earlier when we had applied AC in the working principle of the transformer, we had seen that induced EMF was E1 equal to minus N1 d phi by dt, and flux was the sinusoidal in nature, therefore we can differentiate that flux. Okay, now because of DC voltage, DC current produced, and then I1 into N1 equal to magnetomotive force, which is DC nature, is produced. Now this DC MMF develops a magnetic field, magnetic flux in the core of the transformer, and that developed magnetic flux is also DC in nature. Now since this flux is passing from this coil, then EMF will produce in this coil, and this flux is also passing from this coil, EMF will also produce in this coil. EMF produced in this coil because of flux is E1, and EMF produced in this coil because of this flux is E2. Okay, E1 equal to minus N1 d phi dc by dt, and E2 equal to minus N2 d phi dc by dt. Now if you are having a waveform which is sinusoidal in nature, and consider this waveform is of flux, this one is the maximum value phi m, phi equal to phi m sine omega t, and this one is the omega t, and this one is the also another kind of flux which is DC in nature, phi DC, this one is the time. Here frequency of this flux is f, and here frequency of this flux is 0. Frequency of any DC waveform is 0. Okay, means this DC waveform is constant in nature. Even if you change the time, magnitude of this DC flux will always remain constant. Now you know the derivative of constant value is 0. Since this flux is DC, then d phi dc by dt equal to 0, and then E1 will be equal to 0. Similarly, E2 will also be equal to 0. Means induced EMF at primary equal to 0, and induced EMF at secondary is equal to 0. Now, what, as you know, transformer is used either to step up or step down the voltage at the source side. Suppose this one is 110 volt, and when we do a step up, this becomes 220 volt. Then this is called a step up. When this one is 220 volt and we make it 110 volt this side, then it is called a step down. And this is the primary use of the transformer. But here we can see that induced EMF at the primary terminal is equal to 0, and induced EMF at the secondary terminal is 0. At the secondary winding also 0. Means there is no step up and step down function is taking place. Means we can say that there is no transformation action is happening. Hum ye keh sakte hain ki transformer ka primary voltage tha, secondary ya par aake na ghat raha hai na bar raha hai. Primary mein jo induced voltage tha, secondary mein induced voltage jo hai, dono equal to 0 ho gaya. Means transformation action ho hi nahi raha hai, means step up step down ka process nahi ho raha hai. इसका मतलब अगर हम कोई डीसी अप्लाई करते हैं तो ट्रांसफार्मर में ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन एक्शन खत्म हो जाता है. मींस देयर इज नो ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन एक्शन इन द ट्रांसफार्मर व्हेन इनपुट ऑफ द ट्रांसफार्मर इज गिवन एज ए डीसी वोल्टेज सोर्स. दिस इज द वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इंपोर्टेंट फैक्ट. एंड अनदर इंपोर्टेंट फैक्ट, व्हाट विल हैपन इफ यू डीसी अप्लाई टू द ट्रांसफार्मर. दिस वन वाज द फर्स्ट इंपोर्टेंट फैक्ट. And second important fact I am telling you. Second important fact. Now, as you know, this one is the coil on the primary winding of the transformer, and this one is the coil and the secondary winding of this transformer. You can represent coil like this. Coil. As you know, you have already studied in second unit RLC circuit. If there is a coil, that coil has resistance and inductance both into it. This coil is equivalent to this R and inductance XL. Means this coil is having impedance Z. This Z can be written as here Z equal to R plus JXL. Okay, means Z equal to R plus J 2 pi F L. Every coil, this coil is having R and inductance, resistance and inductance. Agar inductance hai, to uska jo hai inductive reactance hoga. उसी तरह से ये क्वाइल है तो इसमें भी रेजिस्टेंस होगा, इसमें भी इसका इंडक्टेंस है तो रिएक्टिव इंडक्टेंस होगा. नाउ व्हाट विल हैपन व्हेन वी विल गिव डीसी. जब डीसी देंगे तो हमारा ऑन डीसी, जब डीसी देंगे व्हेन डीसी इंपोज्ड, डीसी इम्पोज, तो डीसी में फ्रीक्वेंसी क्या होता है, जीरो. हमने इस वेवफॉर्म से बताया डीसी में फ्रीक्वेंसी जीरो होता है. मींस जेड विल बी इक्वल टू आर व्हेन डीसी इज अप्लाइड. नाउ कम टू दिस पॉइंट, व्हेन डीसी इज अप्लाइड मींस एट एसी जेड इक्वल टू आर प्लस जे एक्स एल एंड एट डीसी जेड इक्वल टू at AC Z equal to R plus JXL and I equal to V by Z. मान लिया कि ये प्राइमरी में हम करंट निकाल रहे हैं, I1 equal to V1 by Z1. यहाँ का इंपोडेंस जो है प्राइमरी का R plus JX Z1 होगा, ठीक है. जब AC अप्लाई किया तो V1 by R plus JXL इसको लिख सकते हैं. And at DC, when DC applied, तो Z equal to क्या हो जाएगा, R plus JXL. DC पर ये जीरो हो जाएगा, तो इक्वल टू क्या हो जाएगा, R. मींस I इक्वल टू I1 इक्वल टू V1 by Z1 इक्वल टू V1 by R. अब जो है किसका वैल्यू ज्यादा है, ये DC पर जो करंट है हमारा और AC पर जो करंट है हमारा, दिस वैल्यू इज हायर, दिस Z1 एट AC इज हायर, देयरफॉर दिस IAC विल बी लेस. और जब डीसी अप्लाई करेंगे तो इंपेडेंस का वैल्यू घट जाएगा, ये घट गया तो टोटल करंट का वैल्यू हमारा बढ़ जाएगा. मींस एट डीसी हाई अमाउंट ऑफ करंट विल फ्लो इन द प्राइमरी ऑफ द ट्रांसफार्मर. इन दिस वाइंडिंग हाई अमाउंट ऑफ करंट विल फ्लो बिकॉज इंडक्टेंस का इफेक्ट जो है खत्म हो जाएगा जब डीसी अप्लाई करेंगे. तो इस वाइंडिंग में सिर्फ उस वाइंडिंग का रेजिस्टेंस बचेगा, जिसके वजह से सिर्फ रेजिस्टेंस बचेगा, जिसकी वजह से टोटल करंट जो प्राइमरी में फ्लो करेगा वो बढ़ जाएगा. दैट करंट विल इंक्रीज एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट करंट हाई अमाउंट ऑफ करंट विल, दैट करंट विल बी वेरी हाई मैग्नीट्यूड इन नेचर एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट आवर वाइंडिंग में बर्न. Therefore, we usually don't prefer to apply DC on the single phase transformer. And these are the effects on the single phase transformer when we apply the DC. First is the there will be no transformation action as phi produced will be DC and induced EMF on both terminal, primary terminal and secondary terminal will be zero. And second thing will be magnitude of impedance will reduce and therefore high amount of current will flow that may burn the winding.